Hello everyone, Spencer here from retouchtv.com, and today I want to show you how to create wisps. And this is a cool little blur effect that kind of adds motion to your images. It's very cool and easy to use, and I think you guys will enjoy this. So I'm going to create a new layer. I already set the background to green, and I have my foreground color to a light blue. I want to, we'll play with a couple different colors. So we're going to select our brush tool. You can either click up on your toolbar or you can just hit B for your shortcut. And I'm just going to choose any one of these random brushes. It honestly doesn't matter. I'm going to set my opacity to 100. Do a little bit of a wave. Do some lines. Just cross it. Like I said, this part doesn't really matter too much. It does affect the outcome. But if you want, you can just kind of like play around and do stuff like that. And you'll see what I mean in just a moment. So now what we need to do is go to filter, blur, motion blur, and we have this angle set to 0 and the distance set all the way up to 2000. We're gonna hit OK, and now you get this really fast looking blur, very you know, plain, nothing too special about it. But what we need to do now is I'm going to click Control T to free transform this. I'm going to hold Alt and just drag in this, the top and bottom layer inward a little bit so it's a little thinner. I'm going to right click and hit Warp. And now we have the ability to move these around and create the wisp. And you can do this in any shape that you want. I try to make mine more wavy and follow a different flow so that everything looks like it belongs together. I'll bring this up and then I'll just drag that down a little, fold it over itself, that's totally fine. And you'll see the outcome right now. We'll bring this up so it looks, has a little bit more shape other than just the arch. There we go. I'll hit enter. And as you can see, we have this really cool wisp effect. And it's very easy to do, like you just saw. That took me seconds to create this. And as soon as you understand how to do it and do more different designs and practice it, you'll be able to create awesome looking effects. I'm going to create another layer and just grab this yellow here. And we will do another one, and I'll explain the brush, this first part, a little bit more. So if we add a little bit of a brush, obviously this part is going to be more thick in the blur than the other parts. So if we drop this down and just do a little bit of a line right here, that's going to be a lot thinner part of the blur. And sometimes that's what you want. So it really depends on your approach. What is it that you're trying to do with this blur? Do you want to have it very thin at the top and then a very thick layer? This is what I'm doing, as very thin layer at the top. It's a lot thinner, hardly even noticeable right underneath. Very thick, and then somewhat thin and lighter at the very bottom. So if we do Control F to repeat that blur, you can see exactly what I mean. Everything that was light is light. Everything that was thick is thick. Everything that was just hardly noticeable is still hardly noticeable, but it adds that effect. So you have to keep that in mind. So I'm going to hit Control T and I will begin to warp this image. And let's just do something very simple. I'll bring these down. I'll bring these up. I'll drag this like that. That one outward. This like that. That one outward. Let's add a little bit more shape to this. And then right here in the center, just bring that down a little bit. Cool. And hit enter. There we go. We have our wisp. Very cool, isn't it? Look at that. That's super easy to do. Has an awesome effect. And you can do this for anything that you want. It can be like a fantasy sort of image. I do it to kind of, I've used it before to create a little bit of a motion. So if you enjoyed this tutorial and you want to see more, hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't already. Make sure you check out my other videos. I do tutorials, I do fun stuff, I do all sorts of things that have to do with Photoshop and design and photography and everything like that. If you want to see more, check those out. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.